Welcome back to MidnightO2 Season 1, Episode 11. How are you feeling tonight? This is your host, Amy, and today I'd like to talk about graduation. So I wish that there are certain things that someone said to me when I graduated from college, which was not so long ago, but after I graduated from college, I realized there are a lot of things that I didn't know but I should have known. So, first of all, congratulations, class of 2020. This year was very difficult for all the countries and for all the people in the world. Stock market crashed and people lost their jobs. There are a lot of businesses were forced to file for bankruptcy. And you just graduated, you know. I believe people who just graduated, they want to hear something positive, something like, oh, you're going to have a great future if you just work hard. But I realized working hard is not enough. It's something that's necessary, but it also depends on the timing, the situation, and how much that you have. And how much, I don't mean by money, sometimes it's your efforts and as well as the plans that you have, if it's reasonable or if it's logical. And I wish someone was there to tell me this, that if you want to follow your passion, make sure you actually have a plan instead of just blindly think that you're going to make it because you love something. And second point is that I hope you will continue to stay healthy. So when I was younger, it's not like I'm old, but when I was a little bit younger, like 15, 16, or just 18, I was hanging out with my friends most of the time, and I didn't care what I was eating. I didn't have a healthy habit. It's just, I couldn't stress enough. Health is very important, and I don't want you to realize this too late. So I just want to say, take care of yourself and actually eat good food and eat healthy food and have exercises. And those are just very important. I sound very old. I can't believe I'm saying this in my mid-20s, but it's so important that you maintain a healthy habit or else you might regret later on. And I hope you will always choose the option that makes you happier. So what I mean is that I believe in the future, starting from now, you step out of the school, step off your department with your degree, you're going to make a lot of choices in life. From choosing a partner, getting married or not get married, get this job, take this offer or not take this offer, have this baby, or just, you know, they're going to be thrown on your face and you have to make the choice for your life. I hope you can always take that choice. Make the choice that makes you happier and that will make your life different from those people who are miserable in their late 40s or 50s when they're stuck. And right now you are free. You are a free person right now. And whatever it is, don't commit crimes. Don't. This sounds very obvious, but I will support whatever passion or career you choose as long as it's not hurting someone else. And my last point is that be kind. It's very important and it sounds very obvious too, but then it is very difficult once you step out of the society, step off the school into the society. You're going to face different situations and different people and have different clients who make your life very, basically very hard. They bring struggles into your life and you have to work overtime sometimes. And just like what I wrote in one of the poems in my book, that it takes guts to be kind to people these days. I actually believe that, especially if you want to treat people with respect, and sometimes you want to be treated with respect. Are you going to take that job just because they offer a higher pay to you, but they don't respect you as a human being? There's just a lot of questions that you have to ask yourself. And I hope you never lose the soul in you right now. The soul that is young, that is brave, and that is willing to make differences in the world. And I hope you don't forget how you feel right now, fresh out of college. And I hope your mind of trying to be kind to people, to the world, will never be washed away by the society, sometimes cruelty or just unfair situations. Because even though I just stepped out of college not so long ago, I realized there's a lot of unfair situations sometimes in a work field, and people are going to blame each other. And if that happens on you, what character are you going to be in this situation? What decision are you going to make for yourself and for the future? So I'm really leaning to the side of being kind. That's why this is so important, that I wish more people could do it and believe in it. And in the future, I hope you don't let other people define your life. This also sounds very obvious and like an of course statement, but then in the middle of working, we are always going to forget that why we started it in the first place. And we might forget that we used to be young and we used to guide our own lives. So I hope you can always be in the driver's seat of your own life, because it is so important for you to make the decisions for yourself and be responsible for them. Another point is that I hope you cherish all the friendships that you've made in college, because it is difficult to make friends after you graduate. It is true that the older people have been telling us, you know, like childhood friends or your friends at school who used to go to places and libraries with you. They are great people in your life and you should keep them, hold on to them if they're great friends. And because as we go on in life, we're going to become adults, so quote-unquote adults. And it's very difficult for us to make time for each other, you know, but people do. It takes dedication and friendship starting from now on. You won't see each other every day, but I hope you cherish the friendships in your life, because it is important to have good friends. You share ideas and, you know, talk about work-life balance. Just, it's nice to have someone to share those feelings and emotions with you. So keep them. And you're lucky if you have many, many good friends. Or if you just have one, that is enough too. If not, I'll be your friend. Well, anyways, years ago, there was a teacher who told me that everyone should be a teacher after they graduate. And I was like, what? What does that mean? Because I don't want to teach, because I know I'm pretty impatient and I'm not going to teach like subject or class. And I asked him, what does that mean? And he said he means that be a teacher in your life, as in teach someone the lessons you learned in life, or just share your experience with others. That's what he meant. And, you know, it starts to make sense now as I step out of the school and going through different companies and different jobs. It's important to share your experiences with others, and sometimes by sharing it, you will be learning more and more, and you will meet people that you didn't expect that you'll meet, but it was nice and necessary to meet them. And people you meet are going to change your life. So make a wise decision by meeting and keeping those people in your life. And when it comes to graduation season, it's very normal and common to see on your Facebook wall that who and who is going to Harvard, Stanford, going to MIT for a good degree and for med school, law school. And you're just sitting there in front of your laptop thinking, am I behind? I actually, you know, my friends told me a lot about this. Like, I was talking with my friend was saying, oh, I just saw another friend of mine. She's going to an art school in New York, and this friend got into a dental school. And even though I don't even like what they're doing, I don't even like art, I don't like dentist, like, why do I feel very weird when I see that? And I just like laughed, because sometimes I feel the same. And I think it's very important to learn to celebrate your friends' achievements. I think that's difficult to do and difficult to learn, because, you know, we're human beings and sometimes we get jealous and we're envious of others. It's natural. But I hope that you will one day stop comparing yourself with others, no matter if it's their degree or the school that they go to or the job that they do or the amount of salary they get paid. I hope you could be yourself and be happy instead of comparing yourself with other people's achievements and who they are. Because everyone has different past and timeline is also very different. You don't know what the person has gone through in his or her life, so it is unfair for you to judge that success comes easily for the person and it's difficult for you. Because, you know, people just want to show their best sides most of the time. And we shouldn't judge easily. Just focus on yourself, focus on your entire life instead of comparing it with someone else's. And for me, I always say that I'm a storyteller. I collect people's stories and I share them with, you know, more people, and I share my stories with you too, like this. I hope you will develop your own stories and be a book. Be a book that people want to read and read again. Yeah. So be an interesting person. And I'm looking forward to see how you're going to go about your life. And just be inspired and do creative things and be comfortable with what you're doing. That will make your life the happiest. Yeah. And congratulations again, class of 2020. So that was a short speech for people who graduated this year. And for those who didn't graduate or who are about to graduate, maybe I will figure out more things in life and come back next year to tell you a different speech or see what I have changed and see how you're doing. And again, for story sharing, you could email me at ahcpoetry@gmail.com. And we could talk soon next week. And have a good night.